Welcome back to latest TV news. Now, Spandau Ballet were one of the biggest bands in the world back in the 80s. And after a recent reunion, the saxophonist Steve Norman has taken a short break from the band to do his own thing. Bill Smith caught up with him ahead of his show at the Old Market in Hove tomorrow night.
I'm joined in the studio by Steve Norman, founder and longtime member of Spandau Ballet, and a great session musician in his own right. Steve, you're doing something in Brighton tomorrow. Tell us about it.
Well, it's a home gig because, you know, I've lived in Brighton now for 4 or 5 years and, you know, I've always had a connection with the place. And so it feels extra special to be... I'm playing at the Old Market tomorrow night.
That's in Hove, isn't it?
In Hove.
Yeah.
And, yeah.
Is it a Spandau gig or is it Steve?
It's just me. I mean, with Spandau, we sort of famously, we have our little sort of hiatuses of like 10 or 20 years every now and then. So, you know, we've all kind of built up our own solo projects as well, and this has only been going on for about a year for me. It's up close and personal, live and personal. So it's Q&A, me talking about music that inspired me to be a musician, playing sort of tracks that inspired me as well, different kind of versions really, and a few Spandau, a few new material that I write. Got my band, 5-piece band.
Wow.
And you know, it's very sort of open and honest, and I challenge people to ask the questions that no one else asks.
It's a concert about your career.
Kind of, yeah.
I know you're a writer, you've written some of the Spandau songs, yeah. And of course you're extremely well known for playing that saxophone solo on
yeah,
True, of course.
Yeah, yeah.
I presume you'll be playing that.
I don't think I could get away with not doing it.
Really,
you know?
Okay.
They tend to sing that solo, you know, when I'm playing it. It's very... I feel very proud about that, yeah, of course.
Yeah.
And I'm proud of everything Spandau did. And, you know, I love two passions in my life, my family and my music. And I'm very happy that it's all going well.
Let's just talk about Spandau for a minute or two. Then you joined the band. You started the band. You and Gary were school friends.
It was me and Gary. Yeah, he was in a band. I remember, and we kind of gravitated together in the mid 70s, and we just went out and sort of discovered music together. So we would go to places in London like the Marquee and. You know, various other sort of pub gigs where there was a very healthy live scene in the 70s in the UK. We'd see, for example, this new band AC/DC playing to 20 people in the Marquee Club. We saw that regularly, you know.
Mm.
And from then on, you know, just thought, well, you know, we can do this. And
where did you guys start playing? Where was that?
It's a school band, really. Yeah.
And then
1976 was our first gig.
You were telling me about Blitz.
A few years later, because we got involved in the punk scene, but really on the coattails. It was already established.
We
were a bit young, you know.
Was it the glam scene?
Because people got the punks, let's say, not the ones that wanted to destroy everything. You know, there was a lot of people that gravitated together that were dressing up, really, as a reaction to the dressing down of punk. That's how it goes. You know, youth culture, it always works like that.
So
you kind of rebel against the last thing.
Your contemporaries were what, Mark Harmon?
Once we formed the band, you know, there was this healthy scene which became the new romantic scene and, you know, I guess our contemporaries became Duran, and even back then, Boy George was working as a hat check guy, you know.
Yeah, right.
Until he got pilfering in people's handbags and got the sack, you know.
You had a good singer, or you could have got him, I suppose.
And I tell you something, we did a photo session in a squat that Boy George was in, because it had wonderful, it just looked brilliant. So one of our first photo sessions in 1979, this would have been, of Spandau. We're looking very sort of pomp and... full of ourselves, and George was upstairs. He'd just got out of bed, and he said, "Yeah, what was it? What have you still got that lead singer? I'll sing for you." And John Keeble, our drummer, shouted out, "Well, go on then, go and form a band." Did he?
He sort of did.
Formed Culture Club, of course, you know, that went on to go global.
Were those days great? Do you look back on them fondly?
Absolutely. You know, people say, "How do you feel about it?" You know, we see pictures of the mullet and the pads out here. Proud, really.
So you were at the beginning
of
that. You were also at the beginning of something else, because you lived in Ibiza for a long time.
I did, yeah.
Tell us a bit about that.
In the early 90s, late 80s, the band kind of fell apart.
Yeah.
And I kind of wanted to escape, and I'd always felt comfortable in Ibiza. So I went over there. I ended up living there for 12 years.
And that was pretty much when that sort of exploded, Ibiza cultural club scene,
really. Yeah, it is. The rave scene, yeah. I mean, I'd kind of done all that, but I dipped my toe in and out of it. But I was quite happy just to... be up a small mountain, writing music, you know, sort of just discovering myself, reconnecting with myself.
Did you go to those clubs that were, you know, big at the time?
I got into the scene more because I think the dance scene appealed to me. I still do it, you know. Yeah. I still do gigs where I improvise on sax with some of the best DJs in the world. You know, I worked with Head Candy for a couple of years and as a performer. And before Spandau sort of reconnected after a 20-year
jazz,
absence.
Rock, whatever.
Everything, really. I love it. You know,
musician.
I got a call from last night from a dear friend of mine who said, oh, I'm playing the Pizza Express live stages, which are great sort of new live events that they're putting on. Yeah. I've done residences at these. They're great.
Who do you admire a lot? Who are your heroes?
My heroes? I love music. I'm a fan of music. You know, I had a great opportunity last year. Dear friend Kevin Armstrong, who I'm going to join on stage next week, in fact, he facilitated meeting Iggy Pop, and Iggy asked me if I'd like to join him at Wembley Stadium when he played at Wembley Stadium. It got cancelled in the end, but I eventually got to perform with Iggy last year. Those things, you know, I always think it's important to be a fan, and don't be embarrassed about being a fan.
Yeah.
Once people get in the business, they tend to deny those things. I'm really excited. Stevie Wonder, Elton John, you know, I grew up listening to these people, Motown and certain sax players, you know. I went to see Maceo Parker, I don't know how many times when he was in London last, and I just was at the front looking at him like a fan, because I am. I'm proud of that.
You played with sort of lots and lots of people. I won't go through all the names, but pick out a couple of the special moments for you.
Well, like I say, Iggy Pop last year. Recently, Mark Armand, Holly Johnson, Kim Wilde's friends, you know, Martin Fry, ABC. There are a lot
and
of people
music
from that
with
era
all of them.
Friends of mine, yeah.
And music
so we
with
tend
them?
To, you know, and I actually put some events together as well and you know, get my friends in, which is people that are in the charts, you know. But I still like, you know, new music as well. Really loved Christine and the Queens. And Girlfriend, that is a fantastic
great
track.
New band.
Yeah, right, all new stuff.
Yeah.
Brighton is a great artistic hub.
You live here now?
Yeah, I do. I've been here for about 4 or 5 years. I love the idea of, you know, you get these open house things and, you know, it's all to do with, say, visual arts. But I love the idea of mixing them. So you can mix the visuals and an event where the music is as important as the visuals. You know, open house event for music or something, you know, things like that. But only in Brighton. It's really healthier. It's the nearest you can get to Ibiza, I think. For me, it is, at least.
So you've got this gig on Saturday coming up.
Yeah, very much.
The Steve Norman show with lots of Spandau stuff in it as well. What about Spandau? I hear there's a tour. Can you tell us if Brighton's on it?
There's a mini tour. It's not at this point, but we've just got a handful of gigs. We've got one show in this country in October.
Yeah.
Got a new singer now. Very excited about that. We're just kind of testing the water. I don't think everyone's in complete agreement that we changed the soundtrack of their lives, you know, by replacing the singer. But he left. We didn't have a choice.
Yeah.
So, and we want to carry on because we absolutely love it. So we're all excited about this, you know, this new sort of... he's invigorated the band, Ross William Wilde. Ross
he's
Wilde.
The new singer.
He's a new singer. Yeah. He's a youngster. But, you know, he's kind of made us up our game a little bit. You know, I don't have a problem jumping around on stage, but... it's great to have someone, you know, that can keep up with me.
Thank you.
So, it's all exciting.
Yeah, sounds great. Exciting. Thanks very much, Steve, for joining us in the studio. Make sure you go to the gig Saturday night at the Old Market Arts Centre here in Brighton.